know that's kind of like a stretch to do a long video, and you may seem like, oh my god, this is long as fuck, I don't really want to watch it, but I'm going to a masquerade party tonight. Like, my first ever masquerade party, and it's gonna be so much fun. I've always wanted to do something like this. So enough babbling on, I'm gonna go ahead and get ready, so let's have some fun. Okay, we're gonna double time it, because it's that kind of night. Mother effing washed mother effing out. Strainer's hot. Throw this bitch on. Sorry guys, I have a dirty mouth. It's just who I am. I get it from my mother. Now I'm gonna grab my 18 inch pony. Brush it out first, of course. Okay, let's pin that baby down. Sorry guys, I can't show you. But I have a video where I actually do. That was the harder way to do it. It's so much easier to Velcro this together when you're just leaning back. One of my girlfriends got me this for Christmas last year, and it's a forget-me-not multi-use oil. I'm gonna be wearing some heels. I'll like apply this around the nails, and it kind of just hydrates my cuticles. But I also apply it to my hair. I just love that about people. I love when I hug somebody and I'm like, damn, their hair smells so nice. Like, and you know what? I can pick up this weave and just go like some aromatherapy, you know? Now we go on to the next part, and I'm gonna take my Got to Be Glued, my bamboo brush, and we're gonna clean up these edges. That takes a lot of deep concentration. I didn't wanna talk too much, but now I'm going to take my little e.l.f. palette and an angled brush here that this is what I use for this part. So let's go ahead and take the black, depending on whatever hair color your hair is, and just do a little bit of, you're gonna notice that this little spot where it shows my scalp, I just wanna camouflage that. Just kinda makes your hair look a lot more full. I really like doing this to my hair. I do this all the time, only really when I put my hair up like this. Oh, we can move on to the fun part now. I use the Milani, what is this? Conceal and Perfect Foundation. Oh shit, I forgot. Hold on, I have to. Okay, before we do that, let's do some color correcting, because if you're somebody that has trouble sleeping like me, you need this. Now let's move on to priming the face. And I'm just gonna spread this around her. I feel like I kind of look like that guy from Apocalypto. Moving on. Taking that Milani foundation, I'm gonna start off with one pump. This is very buildable, so I'm just gonna start kind of small and work my way up. I'm going to make sure that this isn't too wet. So this masquerade party is being hosted by this girl that I work with. Her and her husband are hosting it for charity. So you did have to buy tickets to go to this thing. It's in Orlando, I think. And I have no idea what to expect. I don't know what it's gonna look like. It's kind of like ball gown. Everybody needs to be wearing a suit and tie. Gotta check the neck. Okay, next we're gonna take this Fit Me Concealer by Maybelline. I don't ever really put this much concealer on my face, but I think the night calls for it. Okay, let's buff this out. That just helped raise my cheek there. That was nice. All right, so there's that. Now I'm gonna grab my Benai luxury powder. I love this thing. It actually lightens up the powder a little bit. And at first, you know, when I first started using it, I was like, oh goodness, oh no. on days like this, I appreciate it. I call for it. I ask for it. Oh yeah, I want to do a little bit of some highlighting in the mid area. I don't like to bring it up too high because I actually like to bring the bronzer down a little bit. Okay, so let's let this bake. I'm not a huge baker, but like I said, tonight calls for it. I'm just going to use this little guy as my contour because it's super, super creamy. It's so light, but it applies the color that I really, really like. So I'm gonna use it. I love. See, this foundation looks like skin. It really does. It is so silky. I love it. Okay, now let's just hide that double chin there. I'm gonna bring this up because I like to bring my chin a little bit to more of like a look. Okay, so now I'm gonna take my Tarte bronzer. It has a little bit of a shimmer to it and I kinda like that. I wanna keep the contour today pretty sharp. Like I actually want to sculpt out my face. We're doing pretty good. I'm sculpting out the face. I don't want it to look too crazy down here. Sorry, my boyfriend just called me and I just kind of got in the groove of contouring my nose. So sorry you had to miss that. But all I did was I just grabbed this little, this is actually an eyeshadow brush from Cosmopolitan. And I think it's my favorite thing to use as a contour. So I just kind of stick with this brush and do my thing. And then I also just like to bring this in and start carving out the eyes, just so that way it looks like it's kind of going, you know, dipped down. Oh yes, that is sharp. But you know what, I'm not too worried about how my nose is just not really cooperating right now, because I'm wearing a mask that comes to a point and it's gonna hide it, so it's all good. This is a precision foundation brush. So I'm gonna take my ColourPop. This is kind of like a, it's from the Super Shop Cheek Collection. Oh yeah, there we go. Looking a little rosy there. Now, this is something new that I got. This is by L'Oreal. This is Tru Match Lumini Shimmerista. And I did get the peachy one. It's a pretty intense highlighter. Like literally all I do is just kind of dab and I'll start there. That brings it out like nobody's business. Holy shenanigans. If I didn't highlight before, I am highlighted now. I always do the brows last because I don't like to sculpt them out. Is that weird? It's probably a little weird. So what I'm using today is the Huda Beauty Rose Gold Palette. Yeah, I don't know which one to do. I'm wearing all black. I'm wearing like freaking glammed out jewelry and mask. So you're not even gonna be able to really see. So what I think I wanna do is just give my eye a really good shimmer. I think that that would be really good. It would be really nice if I did that. We're gonna mix in Moon Dust and Bubbly. I'm gonna get these two on my fingers. I like to use my fingers if I'm just using one color shimmer, simply because it just goes on like. Okay, I'm gonna take a Bubbly and I'm just applying this literally all over. I like the way this is looking. I'm not gonna leave it like that. I'm gonna apply that moon dust. Whoa. Yeah, let's blend that out, but I still wanna keep reapplying. Yeah, you know what? I'm getting carried away here. I'm like, that's too much, and then I just apply some more. I'm actually just gonna drag this closer to the inner eye. Okay, so now that we have that, we're gonna add just something else to kind of dim this down a little bit. I'm going to grab my Smoky Crease Pro Palette or brush by Sephora. We're gonna go right in here to suede. We're gonna mix suede and sandalwood. Okay. And we're just going to pat this on the edges. Pat, 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 pat. I just want a little glam, like just a little something beautiful peeking through the eyes. Okay, there. Now we added just a little bit of some definition to the crease, and that's really all I wanted. You guys know, there's no talking during eyeliner time, sorry. Now we're gonna go in with the Anastasia Dip Brow. I'm using the color Dark Brown. What I always do, even before anything, I always just kind of grab like a piece of tissue and then I'll just straighten this up. Kind of just make it sharper, you know? But I am going to do my brows off camera and then I'm gonna be right back, okay? Okay, I'm back, brows are done. All done. Okay, now let's just throw on some lashes. I don't have time to show step by step, so let's just keep on moving. Okay, so I think I'm gonna Nicki Minaj it and not do any bottom eyeliner because I don't know what's gonna happen tonight and I'm not trying to have any like fallout or any lines happening on the bottom. So I have this one by ColourPop and then I have this Sephora Red and both of them dry matte. I just don't know which one I want to do more. It sounds like my boyfriend's walking up the stairs. I think he might be here. Oh God, shit, scared me. You know what? I was gonna use the Sephora color, but I think this is working. This is just enough.
Calvin Klein did not do me wrong.
No, Calvin Klein never does you wrong. Never does you wrong.
Never does that.
Well, okay, everybody, this is the final look here. I did go all glitz and glam. This is from Charming Charlie's. I was gonna wait to pull this out and kind of show it in a video until I got ready for the Don Quixote Awards, but I'm pulling it out tonight. Okay, babe. Also, you know what? I did not get this from Charming Charlie's, but I got this right here. I got this little piece from Charming. I got these little ears. Oh my God, I'm only wearing one. Where's my other one? Oh, I know what happened to it. Okay. And I got these earrings from Charming Charlie's as well. So I'm going a little bit glitz and glam. This is my whole outfit here. Boom, 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 boom. And to close up this video, I'm going to show you my ending piece. It's so pretty. If you need to like go like glitz and glam in a fucking second and you're running out of time, you go to Charming Charlie's because it's so glam. So, oh my God. So this is it, everybody. I hope that you really enjoyed watching this video. Oh my God, Sean, you just farted. So I really hope you enjoy watching this video. I'm gonna have so much fun. Just stay tuned for my Instagram so that you can see what it's all about. Love you.
Every time.